Good evening, sir.
Happens to be 3 a.m. When do you sleep, 007?
Never on the firm's time, sir.
Sit down. Jamaica went off the air tonight, just like that. Right in the middle of the opening procedure. We've checked up and Strangway's has disappeared. So's his secretary. She was a new girl. We'd only just sent her out there.
Well, was Strangway's on something special?
Well, he was checking an inquiry from the Americans. They've been complaining about massive interference with their Cape Canaveral rockets. They think it comes from the Jamaica area. Does toppling mean anything to you?
A little. It's throwing the gyroscopic controls of a guided missile off balance with a radial beam or something, isn't it?
More or less. $5 million worth of missile aimed at a spot in the South Atlantic. But finishing up in the middle of the Brazilian jungle's bad enough. Now they're going to try orbiting a rocket around the moon. The American CIA sent a man down to work with Strangways. A fellow by the name of Leiter. Do you know him?
I heard of him, but never met him. Has he found out anything? Anything important?
You'd better ask him. You're booked on the 7 o'clock plane to Kingston, and that gives you exactly 3 hours, 22 minutes. Armor. I'll have a set of background papers to date delivered to you at the airport in a self-destructor bag. You can study them during the flight. I want to know what's happened to Strangways.
Sir?
Take off your jacket. Give me your gun. Yes, I thought so. This damn Beretta again. I've told you about this before. You tell him. For the last time.
It's nice and light. In a lady's handbag. No stopping power.
Any comment, 007?
I disagree, sir. I've used the Beretta for 10 years. I've never missed with a jet.
Yeah, maybe not. But it jammed on your last job, and you spent 6 months in hospital in consequence. If you carry a 00 number, it means you're licensed to kill, not get killed. And another thing, since I've been head of MI7, there's been a 40% drop in 00 operative casualties, and I wanted to stay that way. You'll carry the Walter. Unless, of course, you prefer to go back to standard intelligence duties.
No, sir. I would not.
Then from now on, you carry a different gun. Show him, Amra.
Walter PPK. 7.65 mil with a delivery like a brick through a plate glass window. Takes a Brausch silencer with very little reduction in muzzle velocity. The American CIA swear by them.
Thank you, Major Boothroyd.
Thank you, sir. Good night, sir.
Any questions, 007?
No, sir.
All right, then. Best of luck.
Thank you, sir.
Sir? Just leave the Beretta.
I've never even heard of a Tatiana Romanova.
Ridiculous, isn't it?
It's absolutely crazy.
Of course, girls do fall in love with pictures of film stars.
But not a Russian cipher clerk with a file photo of a British agent. Unless she's mental. No, it's some sort of trap.
Well, obviously it's a trap. And the bait is a cipher machine. A brand new lector.
A lector, no less. The CIA's been after one of those for years.
Yes, so have we. When she contacted Kerim Bey, head of Station T Turkey, and told him she wanted to defect, she said she'd turn it over to us on one condition, that you went out to Istanbul and brought her and the machine back to England. Here's a snapshot Kerim managed to get of her.
Well, I don't know too much about cryptography, sir, but Alecta could decode their top secret signals. The whole thing's so fantastic, it just could be true.
That had occurred to me. Besides, the Russians haven't been up to any tricks recently.
Well, really, I'm not too busy at the moment, sir.
You're booked on the 8:30 plane in the morning. If there's any chance of us getting a lector, we simply must look into it.
Suppose when she meets me in the flesh, I don't come up to expectations.
Just see that you do. Miss Moneypenny, ask the equipment officer to come in, please.
Q Branch has put together a smart-looking piece of luggage for us. We're issuing this to all 00 personnel.
An ordinary black leather case with 20 rounds of ammunition here and here. Now, if you take the top off, you'll find the ammunition inside. On the side here, flat throwing knife. Press that button there, and out she comes. Inside the case, you'll find an AR-7 folding sniper's rifle, 0.25 caliber, with an infrared telescopic sight. Then, if you pull out these straps, inside are 50 gold sovereigns, 25 in either side. Now, watch very carefully. An ordinary tin of talcum powder. Inside, a tear gas cartridge. That goes in the case against the side here like that. It's magnetized so it won't fall. Shut the case. Now, normally, to open a case like that, you move the catches to the side. If you do, the cartridge will explode in your face. Now, to stop the cartridge exploding, turn the catches horizontally, like that. Then, open normally. Now you try it.
Turn the catches like that?
That's right.
And open ordinarily?
You got it?
Yes, I think so.
Is that all, sir?
Yes, thanks very much.
Right. Joe?
Yeah, that's a nasty little Christmas present. But I shouldn't think I need it on this assignment, sir.
All the same, take it with you. Good luck, 007.
Thank you, sir.
Gold. All over.
She died of skin suffocation. It's been known to happen to cavalry dancers. It's all right, so long as you leave a small bare patch at the base of the spine to allow the skin to breathe.
Someone obviously didn't.
And I know who.
This isn't a personal vendetta, 007. It's an assignment like any other. But if you can't treat it as such coldly and objectively, the 008 can replace him.
You've hardly distinguished yourself, have you? You were supposed to observe Mr. Goldfinger, not borrow his girlfriend. Instead of that, Goldfinger goes off to Europe, and it's only by the grace of God, your friend Leiter, and my intervention with the British Embassy in Washington, that you're not in the custody of the Miami Beach Police.
Sir, I'm aware of my shortcomings, but I'm prepared to continue this assignment in the spirit you suggest, if I knew what it was about. Sir.
What do you know about gold? Not paint bullion.
I know it when I see it.
Meet me here at 7. Black tie.
I've assigned you to Station C, Canada. Group Captain Pritchard here will be your Air Force liaison.
Sir, I respectfully suggest that you change my assignment to Nassau.
Is there any other reason besides your enthusiasm for water sports?
Perhaps this, sir.
Well,
there was a photograph of that man in this dossier you gave us. His name is Duval. Well, I saw him last night at Shrublands, but he was dead.
Oh, no, sir, not possible. He was seen boarding the Vulcan, took off last night.
If 007 says he saw Duval last night at Shrublands and he was dead, that's enough for me to initiate inquiries.
Oh, well, yes, sir, of course.
Who is this girl?
Duval's sister, sir.
Do you know where she is now?
Nassau.
Do you think she's worth going after?
I wouldn't have put it quite that way, sir.
You've only got 4 days, 007. Don't spend your time sitting around.
No, sir. I won't.
Good luck.
Thank you, sir.
Oh, sit down, 007.
Thank you, sir.
No ill effects?
None at all, sir.
Well, now that you're dead, perhaps some of your old friends will pay a little less attention to you for a while, give you more elbow room. You'll need it, too. This is the big one, 007.
That's why I'm out here myself. I take it you're fully briefed.
Oh, yes, sir. But there's one thing I don't understand. If our Singapore tracking station is correct about the rocket not landing in Russia, then where did it land?
We assume it's Japan. Mind you, all this is pure guesswork. But the PM wants us to play it with everything we've got.
And aerial reconnaissance?
Every inch photographed, nothing.
Are the Japanese equipped to launch such a rocket?
We don't think so.
And who else is?
That's what you've got to find out, and fast. Before the real shooting starts, this damn thing could blow up into a full-scale war. When you get to Tokyo, go to that name and address. Our man Henderson will contact you there.
Henderson?
Captain here, sir. We're underway. Pull ahead.
Right. Well, that's all.
Thank you, sir.
007.
Sir?
We've only 3 weeks before the Americans launch the next one. You know that, don't you?
Oh, yes, sir.
And my sources tell me the Russians are planning one even earlier than that. So move fast, 007.
Yes, sir.
I'm relieving you from Operation Bedlam, 007.
But, sir, Blofeld's something of a must with me.
You've had 2 years to run him down.
Does this mean you've lost confidence in me?
I'm well aware of your talents, 007. But license to kill is useless unless one can set up the target. I'll find you a more suitable assignment. That's all.
Sir, under the
circumstances... That's all. Request granted.
Star of South Africa, 83.5 carats rough, 47.5 carats cut.
The Akbar Shah, 116 carats rough. Are you paying attention, 007?
The Akbar Shah, 116 carats rough. But surely, sir, there's no need to bring in our section on a relatively simple smuggling matter.
Sir Donald has convinced the PM otherwise. May I remind you, 007, that Blofeld's dead. Finished.
The least we can expect from you now is a little plain, solid work.
Good morning, gentlemen.
Morning.
Sir Donald will see you now.
Thank you. Good morning, Sir Donald. This is Commander Bond.
How do you do, Commander Bond?
Sir.
Please sit down.
Thank you.
Sherry?
Not for me, thanks. Doctor's orders.
Commander Bond?
Yes, thank you.
You've been on holiday, I understand. Relaxing, I hope.
Oh, hardly relaxing, but most satisfying.
Well, cheers. Cheers.
Pity about your liver, sir. It's an unusually fine Solera. 51, I believe.
There is no year for sherry, 007.
I was referring to the original vintage on which the sherry is based, sir. 1851. Unmistakable.
Precisely. Tell me, Commander, how far does your expertise extend into the field of diamonds?
Well, how does substance found in nature, the cut glass, suggest marriage? I suppose I've replaced a dog as a girl's best friend, and that's about it.
Refreshing to hear there's one subject you're not an expert on.
Yes, well, then, perhaps I'd better give you a brief background into our problem. 80% of the world's diamonds come from mines in South Africa. Most are dug out of shafts of diamond-bearing clay at depths of up to 3,000 feet. The whole process, from start to finish, operates under an airtight security system. It's an essential precaution. Even though the industry prides itself on the loyalty and devotion of its workers. Naturally, the security measures tend to ensure that loyalty, as do the extensive amenities and social services we provide. There's a permanent staff of doctors, nurses, even dentists. The whole process, from start to finish, operates under an airtight security system. It's a necessary precaution. Even though the industry prides itself on the loyalty and devotion of its workers.
Next!
The course, no security system is perfect. We've always accepted a percentage of smuggling. But over the past 2 years, despite all our precautions, it's gone up alarmingly. Even more alarming is the fact that none of the stones have reached the market.
Sir Donald thinks someone's stockpiling them.
What concerns us is the possibility of someone either dumping the stones on the market to depress prices or...
making Europe agree to perpetual blackmail.
Exactly. What we need to know is who the stockpilers are.
Several recent murders in South Africa have complicated matters. If they shut down operations before we discover them...
it would be catastrophic for us. And for the government.
Well, I've always rather fancied the trip to South Africa.
You're going to Holland. For some time now, we've had our eyes on a professional smuggler called Peter Franks. He's due to leave for Amsterdam.
Do we know who his contacts are?
We do function in your absence, Commander.
Married by any chance, are you?
Good morning, 007.
Good morning. Insomnia, sir?
Instructions. You haven't much time. I'll explain as you pack.
Pack, sir?
Three of our agents have been killed during the last 24 hours. Dawes in New York, Hamilton in New Orleans, and Baines in the Caribbean.
Oh, Baines. I rather like Baines. We share the same bootmaker. Coffee? Sir? I take it these killings are connected.
That's precisely what you're going to find out. Baines was working on a small island in the Caribbean called San Monique. Dawes was in New York, keeping an eye on its prime minister, one Dr. Kananga. Hamilton was on loan to the Americans in New Orleans. Is that all it does? By the way, congratulations seem to be in order. The Italians were most impressed by the way you handled the Rome affair.
Thank you, sir. Sugar?
Oh, thanks.
Well, the authorities were more than helpful.
There's one small complaint. They seem to be missing one of their agents, a Miss Caruso.
Oh.
You wouldn't happen to know where she is.
Ah, Miss Moneypenny.
Morning, Moneypenny.
Good morning, sir.
It's only the hour that's indecent.
Really? I've got your ticket to New York. Q has repaired your wristwatch. And some background material on San Monique.
Thank you, Moneypenny.
I'm sure the overburdened British taxpayer would be fascinated to know how the Special Ordnance Section disperses its funds. In future, Commander, allow me to suggest a perfectly adequate watchmaker just down the street. Good God.
You see, by pulling out this button, sir, it turns the watch into a hyper-intensified magnetic field, powerful enough to even deflect the path of a bullet, at long range, or so Q claims.
I feel very tempted to test that theory right now. If you don't mind, Commander, my spoon.
Oh, sorry, sir.
Thank you. Dr. Kananga is at present in New York. The CIA have been informed, and they're helping out with the surveillance. Your flight arrives at 11:30 a.m. Now, where did I leave my coat?
Oh, allow me.
Thank you. Come along, Miss Moneypenny. Morning, Bond.
Sir, Miss Moneypenny. Thank you.
Goodbye, James.
Good morning, sir. Calthorpe. Chief of Staff.
What do you know about a man called Scaramanga, 007?
Scaramanga? Oh, yes. The man with the golden gun. Born in a circus, father the ringmaster, possibly Cuban, mother English, a snake charmer. He was a spectacular trick shot artist by the time he was 10 and a local Rio gunman at 15. The KGB recruited him there and trained him in Europe, where he became an overworked, underpaid assassin. He went independent in the late 50s. Current price, $1 million a hit. No photograph on file, but he does have one distinguishing feature, however. A superfluous papilla.
A what?
A mammary gland. A third nipple, sir. He always uses a golden bullet, hence man with the golden gun. Present domicile unknown. I think that's all. Why, sir? Charming trinket. Even has my number on it.
Precisely.
Well, obviously, it's useless as a bullet. I mean, sir, who would pay $1 million to have me killed?
Jealous husbands, outraged chefs, humiliated tailors. The list is endless. Moreover, this trinket, as you call it, was sent with a note requesting special delivery to you. It's initialed with an S.
Scaramanga's fingerprints were on it. They've been verified by the CIA.
Why would he alert me?
Psychological. He counts on his reputation to terrify his intended victim.
Thank you, gentlemen. I'm relieving you of your present assignment, 007.
Sir?
Yes?
The energy crisis is still with us. I respectfully submit that finding Gibson and his solar cell data is even more important than ever.
It is indeed. And I can't jeopardize it or any mission by having Scaramanga hop up and put a bullet in you. I'll endorse your request to resign. Or you can take a sabbatical and go to ground until this matter's settled.
Or until he kills me.
Nobody knows where he is or what he looks like. So I think it's fair to assume that he has the edge on you. Wouldn't you agree? That's all, 007.
If I found him first, sir, that might change the situation.
Dramatically, wouldn't you say? Good day, Bond. Hello, James. We've been expecting you.
Good morning, sir.
There's been a change of plan. You probably recognize my opposite number in the KGB. General Gogol. And I believe you're familiar with Major Amazova.
Enough to know which brand of cigarette she smokes.
Our respective governments have agreed to pool their resources to find out what happened to our submarines.
We have entered a new era of Anglo-Soviet cooperation. And as a sign of Russian good faith, I'm prepared to make available to you the microfilm recovered by Agent Triple X.
With considerable ease, I might add.
Don't bother with it, sir. It's useless. I examined it on the boat.
I assure you it is quite genuine.
Except that the vital technical information has been taken out. This was only intended to whet our appetites. Maybe Q can make something out of it.
007, at last.
Good morning, sir.
I think you know Frederick Gray, Minister of Defense.
Commander.
Minister, Q.
007.
Moonraker?
What do you know about Moonraker?
What I read in the newspaper, sir.
Then you'll know that Moonraker, the space shuttle, was being flown over here on loan from the Americans on the back of a 747.
Yes, which crashed somewhere in the Yukon. Aircraft and shuttle total destroyed, correct?
That's the official version.
The truth is rather more disturbing, 007. Look at this. Now, that's the scene of the crash. Wreckage strewn over a large area. That's all that's left of the fuselage.
We've been through it with a fine-tooth comb, but there's no sign of Moonraker. Not a trace.
Are you suggesting the shuttle was hijacked in midair?
That's for you to find out, 007.
Shuttles are built in California by Drax Industries.
Yes. We were responsible for the safety of that shuttle, Commander. The United States government is justifiably concerned.
I can imagine. Then California must be the place to start.
I agree.
Don't make any mistakes, 007. The situation is critical. We've got to find that shuttle.
Yes, sir. That's all, gentlemen.
Just a minute, 007. I've got something for you.
Roll up your right sleeve, will you? This is now being issued as standard equipment. Strap it on your wrist. It's activated by nerve impulses from the wrist muscles.
Like this?
Oh, thank you, 007.
Be careful, will you?
Yes, Keith.
10 darts. 5 blue-tipped with armor-piercing heads, 5 red-tipped cyanide-coated, causing death in 30 seconds.
Very novel cure. We must get them in the stores for Christmas.
Good morning, gentlemen.
Ah, there you are, 007.
Minister, Chief of Staff.
Are you aware of our ATAC system, 007?
ATAC, sir? Automatic Targeting Attack Communicator. Uses an ultra-low frequency coded transmitter to order our submarines to launch ballistic missiles.
5 days ago, our spy ship, St. George's, was sunk in the Ionian Sea. She was equipped with ATAC. Now, if that transmitter were to fall into the wrong hands, it would render our entire Polaris fleet useless.
Every order could be countermanded.
Worse, our own submarines could be ordered to attack our own cities.
Have we begun a salvage operation, Minister?
An official operation was out of the question. The St. George's was off the Albanian coast.
We asked Sir Timothy Havelock, the marine archaeologist, to secretly locate the wreck. Before he could send in his report, he and his wife were killed by a Cuban hitman, Hector Gonzalez. The Greek police were able to identify Gonzalez from a description given to them by Melina, Sir Havelock's daughter. Operation Undertow. The information's all here. Now, Gonzalez is at a villa near Madrid. Isolate him and apply the necessary pressure to find out who hired him. You were meant to question Gonzalez, not let Miss Havelock perforate him.
I quite agree, sir.
We'll have to tell the Prime Minister Operation Undertow is dead in the water. She'll have our guts for garters.
If you care to look again at page 2, paragraph 4 of my report, sir, you will note that I saw someone paying off Gonzalez. Now, assuming that that was for Havelock's murder, then there is still a glimmer of hope.
I don't follow.
If we could identify that someone...
Why don't you try the identigraph?
Yes, sir.
Well, get cracking, 007.
Minister.
Good morning, 007.
Morning, sir. Minister.
Commander.
I think you know Jim Fanning, our art expert.
Yes, hello, Jim.
James?
Do you know what this is?
Well, it looks like a Fabergé egg, sir. One of the jewel eggs made by Carl Fabergé as an Easter gift for the Russian royal family. They're priceless and very rare. This one contains a model of the Imperial State Coach.
Top marks, 007.
Thank you, sir.
Except it's a fake. Now, there's the real thing. It's being auctioned at Sotheby's this afternoon.
This is the fourth egg to turn up at auction this year. It's from none of the usual sources. Anonymous seller, numbered Swiss bank account. I'd say that the vendor was a Russian. And now this turns up. A near-perfect forgery.
I think Commander Bond should accompany you to the sale.
Splendid. I could use an extra pair of eyes. Perhaps we could try and spot the seller. They usually turn up out of interest or perhaps just to bump up the price.
Thank you, Fanning.
Not at all.
If it is the Russians, it could be an effort to raise currency for covert operations abroad or for payoffs. Either way, we'd better find out what they're up to.
Yes, Minister.
Eyes only, 007. Operation Trove. You'll be replacing 009. He turned up dead in East Germany with that egg in his hand.
I'm afraid there's not much to go on.
Well, we do have one lead, Minister. Property of a lady.
One minute, 47 seconds, sir.
Not too shabby, sir.
But dead, 007, dead. You should have studied the plot more carefully. Fanatical revolutionaries kidnap a millionaire's daughter and hold her captive for 8 weeks. Of course, she could have been brainwashed. Could have turned. Evidently, she did.
With due respect, sir, I played your war games for 2 weeks, and I only got killed once.
Twice. You've forgotten the landmine on the Black Sea beach.
Correction, sir. I lost both legs. I did not die.
You were immobilized.
It can never be the same playing with blanks. It is somewhat different in the field. With your life on the line, you... Well, your adrenaline gives you an edge.
But is your edge sharp enough? That's the difference between a double O and a corpse.
Since you took over, sir, you've had little use for the double O's. I've spent most of my time teaching. Not doing.
Oh, I make you no secret, I hold your methods in much less regard than my illustrious predecessor did. But my duty is to keep you up to par. Too many free radicals, that's your problem.
Free radicals, sir?
Yeah, they're toxins that destroy the body and the brain, caused by eating too much red meat and white bread and too many dry martinis.
Then I shall cut out the white bread, sir.
We'll do more than that, 007. From now on, you will be suffering a strict regimen of diet and exercise. We shall purge those toxins from you.
Shrublands?
You got it.
Minister?
Commander?
Good morning, sir. A new pet, Q?
If 007, you'd ever bother to read any memos sent from my department, you would realize that this is a prototype of a highly sophisticated surveillance machine.
Now that we're all here, you can get on with the briefing, Q.
Very good, sir. Gentlemen, a silicon integrated circuit, the essential part of all modern computers.
No lecture, Q. We're all aware of the usefulness of the microchip.
Well, now, until recently, all microchips were susceptible to damage from the intense magnetic pulse of a nuclear explosion.
Magnetic pulse?
Yes, Minister. One burst in outer space over the UK and everything with a microchip in it, from, well, the modern toaster to the most sophisticated computers and our defense systems, would be rendered absolutely useless.
We'd be paralyzed at the Russians' mercy.
That is why one of our private defense contractors came up with this. A chip totally impervious to magnetic pulse damage. Now, if I place it on the microcomparator and compare it with a chip that Commander Bond recovered from the body of 003 in Siberia, when I bring the two images together...
They're identical. The KGB must have a pipeline into their research company.
It would appear so. 6 months ago, that company was acquired by an Anglo-French combine, Zorin Industries.
I presume, sir, there has been a security check of the plant?
A very extensive one, but we have no leads.
What about Zorin himself?
Max Zorin, impossible. He's a leading French industrialist, a staunch anti-communist with influential friends in the government.
Yes, but with due respect, Minister, the leak did occur after Zorin bought the company.
Precisely why I've already initiated an investigation.
All right, but for heaven's sake, let's be discreet about it.
But of course, Minister. You have exactly 35 minutes to get properly dressed, 007. Two dead, two in hospital, and Koskov probably back in Moscow, if not dead by now.
We're the laughingstock of the intelligence community. Our first major coup in years, snatched from right under our noses by the KGB, only hours after he defected.
No trace of him?
Nothing. And there's this Pushkin matter.
Well, I must be off. Meeting with the PM this afternoon.
We have to nip Schmiertspiernum in the bud. Pushkin should be in Tangiers in 2 days' time. A termination warrant has been issued for him.
This plot to kill agents sounds rather far-fetched, sir. I know General Pushkin.
And you think I don't? I've dealt with him on several occasions.
Our paths have crossed over the years. He's tough and resourceful, but I can't believe he's a psychotic.
Neither did I until today. This arrived from Gibraltar. It was found near 004's body. Your name was on Pushkin's list too, 007.
There are a few things I'd like to check out first, sir. That sniper, for instance.
Yes, I've read Saunders' report. You jeopardized the entire mission to avoid shooting a beautiful girl.
Not exactly, sir. I had to make a split-second decision. It was instinct.
I'll recall 008 from Hong Kong. He can do it. He doesn't know Pushkin. He follows orders, not instincts. You can take a fortnight's leave.
No. Sir. If it has to be done, I'd rather do it.
You were supposed to be in Istanbul last night. I'm afraid this unfortunate lighter business has clouded your judgment. You have a job to do. I expect you on a plane this afternoon.
I haven't finished here, sir.
Leave it to the Americans. It's their mess. Let them clear it up.
Sir, they're not going to do anything. I owe it to Leiter. He's put his life on the line for me many times.
Oh, spare me this sentimental rubbish. He knew the risks.
And his wife?
This private vendetta of yours could easily compromise Her Majesty's government. You have an assignment, and I expect you to carry it out objectively and professionally.
Then you have my resignation, sir.
We're not a country club, 007. Effective immediately. Your license to kill is revoked, and I require you to hand over your weapon. I need hardly remind you that you're still bound by the Official Secrets Act.
Then I guess it's a farewell to arms.
Don't get too many people! God help.
Very well, sir. Thank you. Good night. The Prime Minister's talked to Moscow. They're saying it was an accident during a routine training exercise.
Governments change. The lies stay the same.
What else do we know about the Yana Syndicate?
Top flight arms dealers headquartered in St. Petersburg. First outfit to restock the Iraqis during the Gulf War. The headman's unreliably described. No photographs. The woman on a top is our only confirmed contact.
Would you care for a drink?
Thank you. Your predecessor kept some cognac in the top.
I prefer bourbon. Ice?
Yes.
We've pulled the files on anyone who might have had access or authority at Seven Eye. The top name on the list's an old friend of yours, I understand.
Oromov. They made him a general.
He sees himself as the next Iron Man of Russia, which is why our political analysts rule him out. He doesn't fit the profile of a traitor.
Are these the same analysts who said the GoldenEye couldn't exist? Who said the helicopter posed no immediate threat and wasn't worth following?
You don't like me, Bond. You don't like my methods. You think I'm an accountant. A bean counter, more interested in my numbers and your instincts.
The thought had occurred to me.
Good. Because I think you're a sexist, misogynist dinosaur. A relic of the Cold War. Whose boyish charms, though wasted on me, obviously appeal to that young woman I sent out to evaluate you.
Point taken.
Not quite, 007. If you think for one moment I don't have the balls to send a man out to die, your instincts are dead wrong. I've no compunction about sending you to your death. But I won't do it on a whim, even with your cavalier attitude towards life. I want you to find Goldeneye, find who took it, what they plan to do with it, and stop it. And if you should come across Ouramov, guilty or not, I don't want you running off on some kind of vendetta. Avenging Alec Trevelyan will not bring him back.
You didn't get him killed.
Neither did you. Don't make it personal.
Never.
Bond. Come back alive.
There is one strange thing. When I called our contact in Saigon, he said the Vietnamese only found our sailors 3 hours ago.
How'd they get the paper out so fast?
Somebody at Tomorrow knew before the Vietnamese government did.
How much do you know about Elliot Carver, 007?
Worldwide media baron. Able to topple governments with a single broadcast. Carver owns that newspaper Tomorrow.
I didn't want to discuss it in front of the minister, but that mysterious signal came from one of Carver's satellites. PM would have my head if he knew you're investigating him. I'm sending you to Hamburg, 007. We've arranged for you to be invited tonight to a party at Carver's media center.
They're celebrating the launch of a new satellite because now he has the ability to reach every human being on the Earth.
Except the Chinese, who've refused broadcast rights. James, your ticket, cover story, and rental car reservation. Sign here, please. I believe you once had a relationship with Carver's wife, Paris.
That was a long time ago, Em. Before she was married. I didn't realize it was public knowledge.
Queen and country, James. Your job is to find out whether Carver or someone in his organization sent that ship off course and why. Use your relationship with Mrs. Carver if necessary.
I doubt if she'll remember me.
Remind her. Then pump her for information. You'll just have to decide how much pumping is needed, James.
If only that were true of you and I, Moneypenny.
Yes, 007?
Tell me about the kidnapping of Electric King.
I wasn't aware you had an assignment on this case.
I brought the money in that killed King.
Don't make this personal.
I'm not. Are you?
You're the only one who could seal her file.
Would you excuse us? I will not tolerate insubordination, 007.
What happened?
After Electra King was kidnapped, her father tried to deal with it on his own. With no success. So he came to me. As you are aware, we do not negotiate with terrorists. And against every instinct in my heart, every emotion as a mother, I told him not to pay the ransom. I thought we had time on our side.
You used the girl as bait?
Yes.
The money in King's briefcase was precisely the same amount as the ransom demand for his daughter. It's a message. Your terrorist is back.
I heard of this place.
Never thought I'd find myself here.
Some things are best kept underground.
An abandoned station for abandoned agents. Your calling card.
So what have you got on Graves?
You burned me. And now you want my help.
What did you expect, an apology?
Oh, I know.
You'll do whatever it takes to get the job done.
Just like you.
And the difference is I won't compromise.
Well, I don't have the luxury of seeing things as black and white. While you were away, the world changed.
Not for me. You're suspicious of Graves, or I wouldn't be here right now. So, what do you have?
Nothing beyond the official biography. Orphan working in an Argentinian diamond mine, learns engineering, makes a huge find in Iceland, and gives half of it to charity.
From nothing to everything in no time at all. And his demonstration this weekend?
Probably just another publicity stunt. Now, tell me what you know about this Cuban clinic.
Gene therapy. New identities courtesy of DNA transplants.
So-called beauty parlor. We'd heard rumors of such a place. I didn't think it really existed.
It doesn't anymore. Zhao got away. He left these behind. All from Gustav Graves' mine. I think it's a front for laundering African conflict diamonds.
We need to tread carefully. Graves is politically connected.
Lucky I'm on the outside, then.
Well, it seems you've become useful again.
Then maybe it's time you let me get on with my job.
You've got a bloody cheek.
Sorry. I'll shoot the camera first next time.
Or yourself. You stormed into an embassy. You violated the only absolutely inviolate rule of international relationships. And why? So you could kill a nobody. We wanted to question him, not to kill him. For God's sake, you're supposed to display some kind of judgment.
I did. I thought that one less bomb maker in the world would be a good thing.
Exactly. One bomb maker. We're trying to find out how an entire network of terrorist groups is financed, and you give us one bomb maker. Hardly the big picture, wouldn't you say? The man isn't even a true believer. He's a gun for hire. And thanks to your overdeveloped trigger finger, we have no idea who hired him or why. And how the hell did you find out where I lived?
Same way I found out your name. I thought M was a randomly assigned letter. I'd no idea it stood for...
Utter one more syllable and I'll have you killed. I knew it was too early to promote you.
Well, I understand 00s have a very short life expectancy. So your mistake will be short-lived.
Bond, this may be too much for a blunt instrument to understand, but arrogance and self-awareness seldom go hand in hand.
So you want me to be half monk, half hitman?
Any thug can kill. I want you to take your ego out of the equation and to judge the situation dispassionately. I have to know I can trust you and that you know who to trust. And since I don't know that, I need you out of my sight. Go and stick your head in the sand somewhere and think about your future. Because these bastards want your head. And I'm seriously considering feeding you to them. And Bond? Don't ever break into my house again.
Mom?
Thank you.
Anything?
Craig Mitchell worked for me for 8 years. He passed a full security check and lie detector test every year. Didn't need so much as a scrap of paper to explain any of it. 8 years, five as my personal bodyguard. I found this and three other bloody Christmas presents I bought him about the house.
I don't think he smoked.
You had to kill him. Couldn't bring him in for questioning so that we might actually learn something. When someone says we've got people everywhere, you expect it to be hyperbole. Lots of people say that. Florists use that expression. Doesn't mean that they've got somebody working for them inside the bloody room. What the hell is this organization, Bond? How can they be everywhere and we know nothing about them? I assume we found no trace of White.
No. The agent guarding the door in the garage was dead before you passed him on the stairs.
I passed him on the stairs? Christ.
Mitchell must have killed him when he went out to check the perimeter. You're lucky to be here.
You think White's still alive?
Yes, I do.
What is it?
Craig Mitchell, 45 years old, no living family, gave generously to charity.
Tell me you know more than that.
Our money men went through every bill in Mitchell's wallet and house.
How much did he have?
Less than £100. And about the same in euros and dollars.
Excuse me, Mum. We've done a complete forensic analysis of every note in its traceable history.
Not in the mood.
After you.
This particular note from Mitchell's wallet may be of interest. We introduced tagged bills into Lashif's money laundering operation by intercepting illegal payoffs. We traced money through several of his bank accounts around the world.
It was pretty thin. At the rate money changes hands, you could probably find a tenner in my wallet with a tag.
That's true, Mum. A single bill could be a coincidence, but what about a whole stack? These bills, from the same series as Mitchell's, were just scanned at a bank in Port-au-Prince, Haiti, deposited in the account of a Mr. Slate.
Impress me.
We have a Mr. Edmund Slate returning to Port-au-Prince from Heathrow this morning. His entry documents have him staying at the Hotel des Salines. He's in room 325.
The whole office goes up in smoke and that bloody thing survives.
Your interior decorating tips have always been appreciated, 007. 007, Gareth Mallory.
I hope I haven't missed anything. The PM does prattle on in a crisis. Bond.
Mallory.
I've just been reviewing Bond's tests. Seems you've passed by the skin of your teeth. You're back on active service.
Congratulations.
Thank you. I'll be outside.
I only have one question. Why not stay dead?
You have the perfect way out. Go and live quietly somewhere. Not many field agents get to leave this cleanly.
Do you get out in the field much?
You don't need to be an operative to see the obvious. It's a young man's game.
Look, you've been seriously injured. There's no shame in saying you've lost a step. The only shame would be not admitting it until it's too late.
Hire me or fire me. It's entirely up to you.
If he says he's ready, he's ready.
Perhaps you can't see it, or maybe you won't.
What exactly are you implying?
You're sentimental about him.
As long as I'm head of this department, I'll choose my own operatives.
Fair enough. Good luck, 007. Don't cock it up.
We've analyzed the shrapnel fragments.
You're lucky it wasn't a direct hit, it would have cut you in half. It's a depleted uranium shell, military grade. Hard to get, extremely expensive, and only used by a select few. Recognize anyone?
Him.
Okay. Name's Patrice. He's a ghost, no known residence or country of origin.
So how do we find him?
Well, luckily we still have one or two friends left in the CIA. They're after him for the Yemeni ambassador's murder, and they're getting close. Intel is he's going to be in Shanghai in 2 days' time, probably on a job.
You're to go there and wait further instructions. If he turns up, he's yours. Find out who he works for and who has the list. Then terminate him for Ronson.
With pleasure. Is there anything else you want to tell me?
No. Report to the new quartermaster for your documentation. He hasn't set up shop yet, but Tanner will put you two together. Good luck.
Thank you.
W7. You are ready for this?
Yes, ma'am.
I didn't know Bond passed the tests.
He didn't.
How's the arm, sir?
What? Oh, it's fine. It'll get better.
All pretty shocking for someone unused to field work. So, 007. Lots to be done. Are you ready to get back to work?
With pleasure, M. With pleasure.
Start anywhere you like.
Take your time, 007, but in 5 minutes, the head of the Joint Security Service is going to walk through that door, and I've got to explain to him how one of our agents decided to potter off to Mexico all on his own and cause an international incident.
With all due respect, sir, it could have been worse.
Worse? You blew up half a bloody block.
Well, better half a block than a whole stadium full of people.
You had no authority. None. As you know, we're in the middle of the biggest shake-up in the history of British intelligence. The ink's barely dry on this merger with MI5, and already they're itching for a chance to scrap the 00 program forever, and you've just given them one.
You're right, sir. You have got a tricky day ahead.
This is an official question. Mexico City, what were you doing there?
It's just a coincidence. I was taking some overdue holiday.
Okay, fine. As of this morning, you are officially grounded. I'm standing you down from all operations indefinitely.
Very good, sir.
007? Sir? I don't know what you're playing at, but whatever it is, it has to stop. Now.
So sorry, am I interrupting?
Not remotely. 007, I'd like you to meet Max Denby, head of the Joint Security Service.
Well, it's a pleasure to finally meet you, 007. I've heard a lot about you. Most of it good.
Congratulations on your new appointment.
Thank you.
Suppose we should call you C now?
No, no. Max, please.
No, I think I'll call you C. C.
As you wish. Well, my door is always open, 007, for my employees. This merger's going to be a whole new chapter for us. We're going to bring British intelligence out of the dark ages into the light.
That all sounds lovely.
That'll be all, 007. Report to Q tomorrow for medical, thank you.
Very good, sir.